Calling to order a meeting of the Capital Improvement Planning Committee. It's April 19th, 5:30 p.m. Members here are, I'm John Pereski, chairperson. Carolyn Ness, I'll introduce yourselves, okay?
Carolyn Ness, Select Board Representative.
Jack Davy, at-large representative.
Jeff Upton, Finance Committee Rep.
I'm also at-large member. The first order of business is we have a capital expenditure request from the Highway Department for a mower. And they have some handouts today. Jeff has one and Jack has one. Do you have one?
No, I don't. I didn't get that.
Anybody else want one? Trevor?
Thank you.
Anybody in the audience? Say, yeah, it's public information. It is now. Anyone else? Owen?
Thank you.
This was received by me last Friday.
Yep.
And I guess to summarize, there's a Eversource has a program, correct me if I'm wrong, Kevin, please. Eversource has a program where five towns, they'll pay for a mower for five towns to use almost all of the cost of a mower, like 95% roughly. If five towns use it and there's a lead town, and the program goes for 5 years, and it's Deerfield's turn to be the lead town. The other towns are Gill, Greenfield, Irving, and Northfield. The Eversource, again, will pay for most of it. What they want is the municipalities to mow, when they're mowing the side of the highway, to also do the utility lines. Not up into the hills, but just along, whatever the mower will reach from the highway. So all towns participate in the use of it for 5 years, and at the end of 5 years, it will become the property of Deerfield, right?
Correct.
It's leased. The lease payments annually be $28,000 approximately, and we will receive approximately $26,000 from Eversource. That's kind of the program in a nutshell.
Mm-hmm.
Kevin, you said the participating towns would be billed about $500 annually, and then the maintenance. Could you just explain how the maintenance, that money goes to the maintenance?
Certainly. What they end up doing is since Friday of last week, and granted, today's only Wednesday.
Yes.
Today's Wednesday. Monday was a holiday. Since then, we've been able to get this mower down where it should be underneath the $130,000.
Okay.
Chuck has been very diligent. We actually went down and looked at a piece of equipment today, then a Lancaster. What happens is each town goes ahead and gives in that $500. And actually, we're thinking about bringing it to $600 because that's what Sunderland did the last time they did theirs. Mm-hmm. So that in turn would give us $2,400 a year that comes into it. Now, the advantage that we have is because all the other towns in the past, minus Greenfield, have sent the machine out for maintenance. So we have in-house maintenance. So realistically, even going on the theory of $28,000, and I can very comfortably say at this point, after having the conversation we had today, we could keep it at $26,000, which is basically a zero cost to the town, to include the financing. That would bring us down to basically a zero cost, and that would give us basically $2,400 a year in our coffers for this program in the future. Now, in the future, in the past, what we've done is we've been in this program about 15 years. We did come out of it at one point in time, somewhere between 2011, 2012. Because originally, we got out of it because we were going to quote-unquote buy our own. And then once they decided that we weren't going to buy our own, then we had to back scramble to be able to get back into the program. Fortunately, because we've been in the program so long, they've allowed us to keep our seniority, because otherwise Deerfield would be getting it this year. Actually, we ended up having a meeting Wednesday of last week stating that all the basic information of the program. Again, they came out with the $26,000 a year. This is guaranteed what it was going to be. And there's also a loophole in there because, excuse me, I can guarantee you somebody's going to go, well, what happens if they decide not to do it anymore? In the contract, it basically states that if for some reason Eversource decides not to do this program anymore and not give us the $26,000 anymore, they have to buy out the rest of our lease. It's part of the contract.
Yep.
So okay. It's basically, it's a free mower. I know some people are probably asking, well, you went ahead and you got a regular mower last year. Okay, that's a regular brush hog mower. That does not have an arm, does not extend over. If we were to go ahead and try and get one that would be able to accept both the mower on the back and the side boom mower, we wouldn't be able to afford it. Simple fact. The over the guardrail part of it is about $62,000 all by itself. Again, we're basically getting a $130,000 piece of equipment for free. Right. Granted, it's not completely 100% free, but we still would be paying our $500 a year anyway towards this. So if you really think about it, we're really getting $2,900 a year that's going into it, because I would continually like to use that $500 and put it into that fund. But basically, because if we do get this, I want that extra money in there in case we do have something that's large that happens to it.
Yep.
In the contracts, it basically states that if somebody does something wrong, they're going to end up having to pay for it. Somebody rips a fender. Somebody go ahead and doesn't check the oil and blows out a hydraulic pump. Okay, that was a $12,000 fix. The town that made that happen ended up having to come up with the 12 grand because it was their fault. Small nickel and dime stuff, that's what the money from the $600 a year is from each of the towns. So I personally think it's very straightforward. Mm-hmm. It's a great program, and in 5 years, technically, now we have our own piece of equipment that we can do whatever we want with it. Again, in the past, we only get it for a week a year, and as most of you know, you go down River Road, you go to some of the other places, we just can't keep up with the bamboo and everything else. The advantage to this is as we're going underneath their wires, we're taking care of our stuff at the same time.
Right.
As long as we take care of a majority of the 69 pole miles that we own, that are in our town, then we're covered underneath the contract. And then we can continue to utilize this thing for much more of our own uses.
When you cut off that bamboo?
I went to that class. It was so
depressing.
To be able to take care of your bamboo, make a super long story short, is because you can't do major spraying, you can't do this, you can't do that. You have to, one of the ones that they said is the most effective was you have to cut it and then, bear with me, take a syringe and put it into the stock of every single one that you've cut.
Yeah, like a Roundup kind of thing.
Yeah. You can't do just a regular straight up Roundup on it because it won't work. It's because of what it is. I mean, it's an extremely invasive species.
I have two questions, Kevin.
Yes, sir.
If I can. The first being, can this mower that's being proposed do everything that we have on hand now, the mower that we have on hand?
No.
No. What would be the difference? What is something that we wouldn't be able to do with this mower that we're doing with our present mower? I'm just curious
The mower is just a standard mower that's on the back.
Yep. Okay.
This is what it is. It's the one with the big arm that comes over. So that way it's...
Right, yeah.
We're looking at a 24-foot boom, which will actually give us about 19 to 20 feet of reach.
Mm-hmm.
Underneath this program, they are looking at 16 feet of coverage on either side, or 8 feet of coverage on either side of their pole is what they're looking for. Now, again, going on exactly what John said, is we're not supposed to come off the road with this, and we're not going to leave the road with it. This vehicle will stay on the hard pavement, so we're not going to be going through Hillendale. We're not going to be doing the high tension lines or anything else. The over-the-guardrail mower that we presently have right now that is part of our trackless does not have the reach.
Yep.
And with this, and it's simply with this, it just augments what we have and just makes us much more efficient in what we can do.
I guess that leads, sorry.
That's okay.
It leads to another question then.
Certainly.
As far as storage, do we have room to store this when we need to without creating another headache as far as we don't have room situation?
Well, I mean, we're tight as it is now.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but I mean, we do have the overhangs because we have two overhangs on it. Presently right now, we're storing some of our plows underneath the overhangs. And realistically, if we got extremely creative, we could probably go ahead and get the thing inside.
Okay.
But we'd have to get a little bit creative because the space is pretty tight there.
Now, with the program, how much as far as a time element each town has for use?
1 week.
1 week.
Correct.
So basically 4 weeks out of the year, we'd be without it.
Correct.
Okay. And at the end of five, we own it.
Correct.
At the end of five, we no longer have to lend that out because a new one will be coming online?
Correct. Right. And Greenfield will be the new person that will be purchasing.
When that new one comes online, will we be privy to a week or because we have this?
We're still privy to a week as long as we pay our $500 a year.
Okay.
Or whatever the host town.
Okay.
On.
So if need be, I know we'll have this machine, but
correct.
You know, it comes down to if Greenfield, they with a new machine, if we pay the $500. Now, if we don't pay the $500, we don't have access to the machine.
Correct.
But it does not eliminate. But it does it eliminate us from the program.
Correct. Yeah. If you don't pay into the program, you will be eliminated from the program.
Right. So it would behoove you to stay within the program with the $500 a year. Okay.
Or as time goes on, because I don't want to say it's always going to be $500, you know, because I don't want to say that's all it is.
Right.
2 years from now and say, well now it's 700 or whatever. So yeah. I want to make sure that it's whoever the host town is the one that's actually setting the price of that.
Right.
Within reason. You know, it was $500. I know Sunderland's at $600. I'd like to mirror what Sunderland does is $600.
Okay.
Now, in five more years, Greenfield can say, well, you know what, we'd really like it to be 700. Or they can say, well, we only want six. It's completely up to them.
Okay.
So, sir.
So, Eversource is happy, just so I understand, they're happy or content with Gil, say, just they only have to cut around the poles once a summer? I'm assuming it takes a week for them to do the whole town.
Yeah, well, actually, it takes more than a week to do the whole town.
Well, how do they do it if they don't have the mower?
You get as much as you can with what the amount of time that you have it.
For the week?
Yeah.
So,
we were fortunate.
So
we were
then they're using their own equipment the rest of the summer?
Or they're not doing anything. And then that just makes it all that much tougher for them the following year. See, we're one of the only towns that doesn't have the true over-the-guardrail mower. Every other town already has one. Gil has one. Irving has one. Montague has one.
Okay.
We're one of the few that don't physically have one. Us and I think actually Waitley, because Waitley is in a different group and they're due for a mower this year. So any of the other towns that they've been in long enough, they already have their own mower.
So 5 years from now, there'll be one when, say, Greenfield's running it, for sake of conversation, there'll be 1 week in the summer when we'll have two mowers.
Right.
Correct.
For all the guardrail, right?
Correct. And then the rest of the year, we'll have our own. We can do it whenever we want.
And the
advantage of this one is, like, if you got a light winter, I mean, granted, last year wasn't too bad, but the year before, where you had a super light winter, that would be the prime time to be able to go ahead and just jump into that machine, and you can do some serious clearing with it, for the simple fact.
What have we been doing in prior years when we didn't have an over-the-guardrail mower, and we only had one for a week?
Get as much done as we possibly can.
How?
We get as much done as we possibly can. And
with
that's
what?
Why we have such an overgrowth problem.
With a one-week mower. We borrowed it every week.
Yeah, we have it for a week.
Right,
that's
correct.
All you got done.
And that's so the rest of the time we didn't cut the brush the other side of the guardrail?
We were able to reach what we could with our mower, with the one that's that small one.
The pull behind one?
No. This is the trackless one, the one that's got the snow blower on it, it's got the plow on it, it's got the broom on it. I'm not sure if you've seen
it. So we have another piece of equipment?
That is correct.
Kevin, didn't the town have a tractor that they would put an arm onto it and it had
That's a trackless, that's what I'm talking about, correct.
I'm not talking about trackless. Prior to that, they had a bigger tractor.
That is correct, yeah, the Alamo, yes, yes, we did.
Yes, and they went over the guardrails and stuff. And the question I have is, now we're going 8 feet, is it really necessary for us to have that much? I know it's a good idea, but is it really necessary to have that reach? I know the power company wants it,
right.
But...
Well, you think about this, the further you go, the more clearance you have off the side of the road, the less issues that you have.
I understand, but I just wondered if
that was why I would suggest
that
going further than the 8 feet.
They went a long time with that other arm, and I know it didn't have that reach.
Correct, yeah, that one had about a 14-foot reach.
Right, so we did have one not as big as this and not as much reach. We've had it, they've done that.
Correct, that was the one that the tractor, the last John Deere that we just replaced, but because we didn't want to go ahead knowing full well that we were going to be close to this program, we didn't want to spend the $50,000 or $60,000 for the arm on the side.
No, I understand that program a little bit, but not a whole lot. Mm-hmm. But I had a question when you said you can't do the, because the bamboo seems like the biggest problem.
It is.
So why can't you spray?
Talk to DEP.
Well, I understand that to a certain degree, mm-hmm. and sometimes it's in difficult spots, but seeing it's evasive, don't they bend the rules, or there are certain rules that you can fit in?
Nope.
Not in the previous administration. It's possible that could change in the present administration.
Because if it was just grass and brush, you wouldn't have such a battle.
Correct.
Yeah.
But you're still going to end up having, you know, stuff grow up, you know, a little
well,
like hay.
I know.
In the wintertime, it'll lay back down, and but yeah.
It
no.
isn't as, that stuff, you've got to mow it twice a year.
Oh, anyway.
Yeah. So that's why I'm just saying that is the biggest problem. And then when you do mow it, it spreads because you carry it with that mower,
yeah.
and it's
right.
That's why I say you're spraying. And the power company can't get involved with spraying that.
My,
I know it doesn't get their wire, so it
isn't
that big a deal.
They're saying no, but I mean, obviously they have their own people that take care of their high lines.
Yeah.
And you go through the areas where they have their high lines. I personally don't know anybody that works for them at that part of the situation.
I don't
know part
of
the program per se.
But like you say,
but I mean, if you look at it, it is pretty clean.
Yeah, but I mean, that stuff, like you say, gets spread because we mow it.
Correct.
And someone said that if you spray it when it's flowering, it's easier to kill. And I know Roundup doesn't work on it.
Right.
But I'm just curious. I think that's the only way to handle that stuff is the
Another question, Kevin, if you don't mind.
No, no problem.
Just looking down through the list here, and I'm just wondering if they're coming down the road in the near future, if this is okay, if there'd be additional cost. One thing I see is radio preparation. Would there be, in the future, also in a request for radio? It says radio preparation. I'm assuming that comes with no radio.
Comes with no radio, that is correct.
So would there be a request for monies for a radio down the road?
Probably not, because I have a takeout from one of the replacements that we have.
Okay.
So, I mean, it's not the digital, it's the radio analog. But
what about AC, you know, air conditioning and that?
It's part of the unit.
Part of it?
That is correct.
Okay, part of the cab.
Yes.
That's
well, also, the rear PTO is deleted? So there is
not on that one. That's a sample.
Well, it says minus $778.
Once again, that's a sample.
So it will have a rear PTO?
It will have a rear because we have a blower that fits on the back of our present one right now, and that way we can be cleaning our road at the same time. So that way any material that comes back from the cutting, it will be blown off. Because again, that right there was done before we were able to negotiate with some of the local people.
The arm that goes the boom, Kevin, is it a big process to take it on and off?
Yes.
Yeah,
I
would assume it would be somewhat of a process because you said it couldn't duplicate it, but if it has a rear PTO and you could put your blower on the back, it must have a 3-point hitch there.
That is correct, yes.
So you could put that other one on, but that boom would have to stay on or...
That boom is gone. We traded, that was part of the trade for the tractor.
No. I'm talking about, you said that Jeff asked that question, if you could duplicate, this machine would duplicate what we do now.
With the tractor that we have now, right?
Right. So you could put that tow behind mower, the brush hog you got on this new tractor, but the arm would be on it. So it'd be cumbersome to run.
That would be, yes, that is correct.
And that's why I asked.
I'll leave that as that because Because I'm just thinking horsepower, but if you were trying to run the two of them at the same time, you wouldn't be able to, because there's not enough horsepower to do the two.
No, I don't think you'd run two of them at a time, because you've got to sort of keep an eye on things. I can imagine that. But one other question, Kevin. When you do get this machine, is it limited to 40 hours a week, or could you have, like, two shifts?
I can have three shifts.
Okay.
I can use it for whatever I want, because technically the machine belongs to the town. So I can use it however long.
So you get it for a week, and you could run it 80 hours if you wanted to?
Yeah.
Okay, I was just curious.
Yep.
So you utilize it?
Sure.
So we had a machine of our own. We have a machine of our own prior to this.
Correct. That was the John Deere that we replaced last year.
So you have a new one?
Yeah, remember we went through and we did the John Deere tractor last year?
So when we get this, we're going to have two of them.
Yeah, but the other this new one will not have the bucket on the front, and it won't have any attachments on the back.
But can we sell the old one?
Which one?
The one that we presently use now.
Yeah, but then we're going to end up having to try and configure how we're going to switch the bucket over into this one, because actually, no, you can't even do that. No, because the when you have an over the guardrail mower, you can't have a bucket on it. And that was the whole reason why we're utilizing that new mower, that new tractor, is because it had a bucket on it. Not all the time.
We were mowing over the guardrails before. We had a piece of equipment that did it.
Correct.
Right?
Correct.
Now we're going to have two pieces of equipment that do it.
But not as far as, not to qualify for this program, right? Because you couldn't reach far enough.
That's correct.
So not this, only that, this but that, new that piece of equipment, will qualify just
the tractor all by itself was $170,000.
Yeah, but 5 years from now,
yeah,
we're going to be able to borrow Gill's or Greenfield's
for correct. A week. Yep.
For a week.
And we'll have this one.
Yep. Right, plus the one we already have.
Mm-hmm.
Right, that has...
So it'll be 1 week, 5 years from now, we're going to have three of them.
Well, I don't think you...
No, you don't utilize it.
Yeah, you wouldn't use that, the one that we have now...
Because it has the bucket on it.
5 years from now.
Okay.
It would still be just two.
So we're talking three different pieces of equipment at this point.
That's what
so let's see.
I just see an opportunity to sell maybe an excess piece of equipment.
Maybe in 5 years.
That's what I'm wondering.
Kevin.
The only thing at any point in time, if that was the case, is in 5 years, I would sell the over the guardrail attachment that goes to the trackless.
Yes.
The attachment only, not the rest of the machine. Because the rest of the machine has a snowblower.
Right.
It has.
Right, right. No, I'm talking about the attachment. I'm sorry.
Yeah, the attachment. Okay.
We couldn't do that now?
We do that now, then we're going to be almost back to where we were. We're trying to get ahead.
One, yeah, we'd have two.
I don't like being behind, because obviously we're.
So you're saying you need two of them?
Presently, right now, you know, because we're going to have it, that 1 week it's gone. So now we're going to be down. Or excuse me, that 1 month we're down. So now that's going to take all that time, and Roger can contest on how long it doesn't take very long for bamboo to come back.
It doesn't. I know that.
So
yeah. Okay, all right.
That's why you say the only real solution is to kill that stuff.
Right.
Oh, I'd love to.
Well, maybe we can organize some volunteers. River Road is extremely neighborhood
friendly.
You know, they organized as a neighborhood group, and maybe, you know, we can connect with that group, Kevin, and when you cut, maybe people will have a syringe party.
Yeah.
With, you know, along the
different kind of syringe party, but yes,
yeah. and get rid of the bamboo. I mean, if that's the way they have to do it, I mean, it's very depressing. And if people really want to get rid of the invasives, that is the way to do it.
Either that or dig it up.
Well,
dig it up.
But it is, it's a lot easier.
You're never going to get it all.
Is that right? It gets
yeah,
right
it's a lot easier if you inject with a syringe.
Hmm.
The you know it's just like the horse syringes.
Yeah, yeah. Beyond
you know
the,
I mean it's big syringes, not
like
it's
all
right.
Back to the equipment.
Yeah,
Bruce has.
So I think we can do that.
Sounds like this program every host town has to rent out to the other communities once a year.
Mm-hmm.
So in all reality, say this year, you could for your $500, you could get one from Gill, one from. But
the
other three
towns? Mm-hmm. No.
No, one, you get
no.
One.
Once,
yeah.
One
correct.
Right.
So whoever the host town is sold, so like if we were to be the host town this time, then the only machine that goes to any other town is our machine.
Right, but so who was it last year?
Northfield.
Okay, so
Northfield has their own machine.
Has to send it out?
Nope.
To
Northfield has their own machine. Done. They don't have to give it to anybody because their 5-year commitment is done.
Okay, who's who was still within the five-year commitment?
They were.
They were, now we are.
Nobody,
correct.
Nobody's a host at this point?
Correct.
Oh, okay. Oh, so there's only a host given out once every 5 years?
Correct.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Oh, that's okay.
I missed that part.
That's okay. How about insurance, Kevin?
I would hope that my $2,700 would be able to cover that per year.
Yeah, we put it on the fleet schedule.
You know, I'm sure it wouldn't be very much. You're talking, what, maybe $300 a year, maybe?
It's leased until we own it, so.
Right.
We don't know how that.
And whose insurance covers it when it's lent out? When?
Oh, it'd still be our insurance because we're the ones that still have to cover it. But once again, something dramatic happens to it because it's part of the contract that each town has to sign to be able to be, to utilize this. Each time you go ahead and you drop a piece of machinery at somebody's place, there's an inventory of what it is, any scratches, any of this, any of that. There's a little check sheet, very similar to like when you go and rent the car, you got the little picture of the car. Well, there's a little picture of the tractor. And any of the issues that there are, they make little check marks.
But I'm thinking more of the tractor operator in Gill.
Liability.
You know, for whatever reason, isn't looking and veers into traffic
program.
And gets in an accident with it.
Right.
It's so a lease program. They would cover their own workers' comp if the person is injured, and it would be under their own liability policy if they're operating it in their town. But if we're delivering it, it would be under our policy until it is released to that town. So it is our responsibility under our policy when it is going to deliver it.
I don't want to belabor this, but the car that the tractor crashes into is going to sue everybody. Deerfield, Gill.
Well, that's the cost of doing business. Right. That's the way it is all the time.
It'd be very similar to any of the piece of equipment that we presently have right now. I mean,
yep.
Your liability's out there.
Yep.
I would like to make a motion that we approve this leasing schedule and participate in this program.
Can I interject
sure.
one second?
Sure.
This request is amended to $130,000, right?
That is correct.
For the record.
For the record, $130,000, $26,000 a year.
Back to your motion.
I will make it for the amended amount. Thank you, John.
Anybody second the motion?
I second the motion.
Okay. Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
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 Okay. It's approved.
Thank you.
500.
Thank you, Kevin.
Thank you.
Thank you, Kevin.
Thanks, Kevin.
I appreciate
yeah,
and thank Chuck
yeah, thank
for
Chuck.
For doing the work to
thank
shave
Chuck
off
for us too.
Oh yeah, definitely.
$10,000.
And negotiating.
Yes.
Yeah, Chuck. He's an extremely good negotiator.
I like Chuck.
Yeah, he does a really good job for us. Was there any other business you guys?
No, I don't think so. I think you can.
Okay. Cool. Hey, can I just make a? This is obviously this publicized. I just like to thank the people on River Road. This weekend, they're putting together their little program they do every single year. They go through and they pick up all the trash as much as they possibly can. They combine it all in one spot, and then on Monday morning we'll come by and we pick it up. But
nice.
Historically, they've done this. I've been around since 2010. And they've been doing this every year.
They've been doing it longer than that.
I'm going to mess up the names. But the person that was in charge of it before, she stepped down last year, and somebody else took the reins, and they're doing a phenomenal job. So
that's great.
I'd just like to publicly thank them.
Yeah, thank you.
It's wonderful because they do a fantastic job twice a year.
Yep.
So when I pick up the stuff, I'll ask them if they'd be interested in using syringes. So.
Yeah, please do.
Well, no, you can float the idea because, I mean, that...
I bet you they'd help.
The other thing is, obviously we can look deeper into it, you know, as far as pesticides, whole nine yards. Obviously, we'd have to pay for somebody to come in and spray, but the simple fact is nobody has a commercial pesticide license.
Right.
Because that's what would be required. We did have one
it's
person
herbicide.
On staff that was, did have herbicide. A farm one. But he's not allowed to use it because it's technically commercial.
Okay.
So,
how much is it to get a commercial license, Kevin?
I honestly do not know. So, and then I know this.
It's you have to take a class. You have to take a class.
Right. So I honestly
usually those are free to attend, mm-hmm. but obviously the guy would be on town time
right.
or whatever. But.
Thank you.
Thanks, Kevin.
All right. Thank you.
For the record, Roger Sadowski walked in late. So 5 minutes later, not a big deal, but just there's another member of the committee here.
A couple of other things. At the annual meeting next Monday, town meeting, I will be there Monday evening, so if anybody has questions of the Capital Improvement Planning Committee, I would hope I'd be able to answer them. But I can't be there, I don't know if the meeting is going to conclude Monday or not.
We hope so.
We hope so.
Right, we hope so, but in case.
It's up to you.
I don't know whether it goes to Tuesday or when the next day would be.
Yes, Tuesday.
I need somebody from the committee to stand in for me on Tuesday.
I think.
Do I have any volunteers?
Jeff and I definitely are going to be there. I hope, Jack, you'll be there, and Roger will probably be there.
I'm not going to be able to be there.
So.
You can't be there on Tuesday?
Next Tuesday, no.
I'm going to try to be there.
Okay.
No guarantee, but I'm going to try to be there.
I will be there.
Worst comes to worst, you'll be there, right?
Yes, I will absolutely be there.
Okay, so if you'd stand in for me, one of you two would stand in for me, I'd appreciate it. I'd also like to now schedule the next meeting of the CIPC. We want to go over some possible bylaw changes.
Okay.
And then I'm inviting Bruce to that, because he's already suggested, made some good suggestions. Of course, you're welcome anyway, it's an open meeting, but I can't, and plus, I'd like to see where we stand with a long-term project of our capital needs. But I'm going to be away 3 weeks in June, so I'd like to meet in May if we can sometime.
John, can I just ask you, or you want to go forward with the bylaw changes that are on the warrant?
Yes, we already concluded we should do that.
So is there something different that you want to?
Yeah, maybe some others.
Okay.
We
discussed holding off on this year's changes this year. I felt it would be worthwhile to change what's in there now, what we want to change, and then make more changes if necessary.
John, just so we don't run into any problems, do we need to go over the five-year plan?
Yes.
First?
Yeah, I just wanted to get these couple little administrative matters out of the way.
All right, sure, then, okay.
So, can we meet, I don't know, what's a good night to meet, Tuesdays? We used to meet Tuesdays, right? Normally? CIPC, right?
Keep it on Tuesday.
Want to make it Tuesday? Let me get my calendar. Tuesday the 9th? Not too soon? Does it work for everybody else?
I'm not sure if I have available that evening.
Might not be able to hobble in that day.
Oh, that's right.
About.
Want to make it the 16th?
Maybe the 16th.
The 16th would be.
The 16th
is not booked.
All right, so the next meeting is CIP, Bruce, that work for you?
16 work or not?
No, it will, it will.
What time?
5:30, that's historically been at.
The 16th?
Yeah, that okay?
Yeah, no, I was just, as a Tuesday?
Yes. 5:30 here?
Yep, that's fine.
Okay. Then that leaves, that next item for tonight is the five-year plan. Did everybody get a copy?
Do I have a copy, John?
Roger, you get a copy?
Yes.
Actually, I gave one to Trevor, and I would like another one. I'd like to update it.
Anybody else? Everybody have anybody?
Does it say 4/19/01?
Yes. Yes, it does, yep.
Five-year plan?
We got one for Bruce. Bruce and Ruth. It's the fiscal year 2018 is what was voted by the CIPC this year, so it's, that's already happened. So then fiscal years 2019 through fiscal years 2022 was gathered from information provided by Carol and Kevin, I don't know who else. Carolyn kind of headed it up. So I don't know, do we want to go over every item, or how do we want to proceed with this?
Well, I think we should make just a statement that the bylaws require the five-year plan. It needs to be published, and it needs to have a public hearing. We had already decided as a committee that we were actually going to do a 10 or 15-year plan with some projections out for 20. And So we're doing this as just a bylaw, to meet the bylaw requirements, not that we were going to stick to this plan, because we had already made the commitment to do the long-term planning and to put the time in, and we just set our first meeting, and I feel like we're really committed as a committee, and this is just, I felt like we had to just meet the bylaw, and that was why.
And I think it can be explained that, FY 2018 is recommended by the committee, and 2019 through to 22 is simply something that is tentative, projected, but still has to go through the entire process of the Capital Improvement Committee, the Finance Committee, and the Select Board.
Right, it does.
But this is just a rough draft. Those years are just a rough draft,
right,
of what we're tentatively looking at.
And the, a published hearing is actually at 6:30, so us as a group are just, we just need to look at this. Is there anything that we're missing off the top of our heads? And if not, then we just vote to move this forward to the hearing.
Yeah.
I tried to.
Well, this is what has come forward so far. I'm sure that as we go along, there'll be additional items.
Absolutely. And some of this stuff will be pushed
right
out and corrected
further, right,
or dropped. I mean,
exactly.
This is no, absolutely no commitment,
right,
other than the commitment required by the bylaw.
This is what
departments, 2018.
Yeah. This is what department heads think they might need the
right
next 4 years.
Right.
20. And like, it's a good point. It's not approved. It doesn't.
Right. It still has to go through the entire process. Yeah.
Right.
This is the crystal ball. Fuzzy.
With that, does anybody want to make a motion to approve this?
I would like to make a motion that we forward this on for the public hearing process this evening at 6:30.
Okay.
And I would second the motion.
I prepared it, so I probably should abstain, I guess. Right?
No, why?
No?
You
okay.
Put, you
right.
John, you put the most work in all the time. So why would you abstain from your work?
Just trying to follow Robert's rules of order or whatever
it is. No.
Are we have any further discussion? Any questions?
The only thing I have is I just want to make note that on this we're changing that $28,000 to $26,000 for the mower.
Yeah, good point.
Oh, yes.
Good point.
It's on there at 26, I noticed.
No, on the 5 year plan is
on the 5 year
plan.
On our
5 year
plan.
Oh.
28.
So
right,
I
yeah
amend my motion to make it 26,000 instead of 28,000 on the mower. Okay, that means we're $2,000 less on each.
Each year will be
$2,000
less.
Less.
Yeah.
Skim's ambulance, top loader, 19. We don't need that.
They're requesting it, huh? With CIPC approved, they requested two. CIPC approved one for fiscal year 2018, so.
So if Tommy does not approve the two, there'll be a request for next year.
Right.
Yes.
Right.
But it was recommended by the
it
finance,
was recommended, com- right,
by the finance
committee
and the Select
two
Board
this year
for two.
Okay, any other questions? So then I guess all those in favor of the five-year projection plan?
Aye.
Aye.
It's unanimous. Any other, with that, I think we've covered everything on our agenda tonight. Anybody want to bring new business to?
I just wondering with the structure building code repair for 2019 for $45,000.
45,000 for, oh.
That's the existing senior center, right?
Health and building code repairs.
I believe that is the existing senior center. That was a patch job, but.
That was my point. That's why I said I want to make sure that everybody understands we're voting on the 2018 recommended, and the rest of it is just projected because it hasn't gone through the process. Because when I looked at this, I had a lot of questions on a lot of those numbers because this is the first time I've seen them. And it'll just need to go through the whole process going forward. But it's almost like a placeholder, from my understanding of it, almost like a placeholder for the time being as far as possible anticipated things that we need to address as a town.
And that would obviously be eliminated if the seniors move to the church.
Right.
With that, then I guess I can have somebody make a motion to conclude the meeting. Oh, no, we have time. Let's do the minutes.
That's a good idea. You have a copy of the minutes? Great. Thanks, Jack.
I need one more.
There's one thing on the minutes, on the second page. Maybe I should let you all read everything, but where it's not on the second page, about a quarter of the way down, where it's noted 3540. On the vote, apparently somebody abstained. But I don't know who, and I couldn't tell from the recording who it was, but it was, so we might have to clarify that.
It's 354, you mean? What's 354?
That's just the time of the meeting on the recording. That was just my note.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
And so.
Was it you, Jeff, that abstained, or was it Roger?
I don't care. It has to be in the minutes anyway. It's just the fact that we approved it.
It was approved.
It was approved.
Yeah, it was approved.
I was the only one that voted against. I wanted to, you know, we.
Right, you wanted to do the two at the same time, right?
It's okay.
It does not change the outcome.
I think there's a correction, Jack, on the cart loaders. I think they originally requested two for $10,000 each.
Yeah, you're right. They did it request two, and then they found out they were like $25,000 a piece.
Yeah.
Well, I thought they. Okay, you could be right, but I thought they requested one for $20,000.
No.
Oh, it was two.
No.
They requested two for $10,000 each.
It was two for 20.
Yeah.
Right.
And then that was why it was such
quite a
shock.
Quite a big difference.
Right. It went two to 50 all of a sudden. That's why there was a lot of hesitation. 20.
So that's another reason that we were so confused. And
right.
It was a $30,000 increase in the estimate.
Right. And that's.
It was submitted without a quote.
Really,
and then when they went and got a quote, the quotes came back. The cheapest one was $25,000.
Right.
So it was a shock to everybody. I make a motion to approve the minutes.
As amended with the cart loader.
With the cart loader change. So it just goes to two.
Right.
Thank you, Jack, for doing such comprehensive minutes.
You're welcome, Chair.
Jack does a great job.
So seconded with the amendment, right?
Yep.
So now we just have to discuss or vote.
Anybody, any discussion on the minutes? And all those in favor of approving the March 29th, 2017 minutes as amended? Aye.
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 Aye, okay, unanimous.
Nice job on the notes, Jeff.
Thanks.
Very well. Nicely done.
So thank you, John.
With that, I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
I make that motion?
I'll second it.
All those in favor to adjourn?
Aye.
Aye, we're done.